in this video, we have been given that AD is equal to BC. So if AD is A, then BC, it will be A, and angle ABC is 30 degree and angle ACB is 100 degree, then we have to find angle ADC. So the first method, interangle ABC it is ABC, this angle is 30 degree, this angle is 100 degree, so this angle it will be 180 degree minus 30 degree minus 100 degree, that will be 50 degree. So if this angle is theta, then this angle it will be 50 degree minus theta. And now interangle ADC it is ADC, this angle is 100 degree, this angle it is 50 degree minus theta, so this angle it will be 180 degree minus 100 degree minus 50 degree minus theta, and it is 180 degree minus 150 degree plus theta, that will be 30 degree plus theta. So this angle it will be 30 degree plus theta, and now in any triangle A B C, if BC is A, AC is B, and AB is C, then A by sin A, it is equal to B by sin B, it is equal to C by sin C. And here, suppose AC is B, then interangle ABC it is ABC, BC is A and AC is B, and this angle it is 50 degree and this angle it is 30 degree. So A by sin 50 degree it will be equal to B by sin 30 degree. So A by B it will be equal to sin 50 degree by sin 30 degree, and now interangle ADC it is A D C, AD is A and AC is B and this angle is 100 degree and this angle is 30 degree plus theta. So A by sine 100 degree, it will be equal to B by sine 30 degree plus theta. So A by B, it will be equal to sine 100 degree by sine 30 degree plus theta. And A by B, it is sine 50 degree by sine 30 degree. A by B, it is sine 50 degree by sine 30 degree. It is equal to sine 100 degree by sine 30 degree plus theta. And if we cross multiply, then sine 50 degree times sine 30 degree plus theta, it will be equal to sine 30 degree times sine 100 degree, and it is sine 50 degree times sine 30 degree plus theta, it is equal to sine 30 degree is 1 by 2 times, and sine 100 degree, it will be 2 times sine 50 degree cos 50 degree, because sine 2a, it is equal to 2 sine a cos a. And 2 will get cancelled and sine 50 degree will get cancelled. So sine 30 degree plus theta, it is equal to cos 50 degree. And sine 30 degree plus theta, it is equal to cos, and 50 degree is 90 degree minus 40 degree, and cos 90 degree minus theta, it is equal to sine theta. So it is sine 30 degree plus theta is equal to sine 40 degree. So 30 degree plus theta, it will be equal to 40 degree. That means theta, it will be equal to 40 degree minus 30 degree, that is 10 degree. And now angle ADC, it is equal to 30 degree plus theta. That will be equal to 30 degree plus 10 degree. That will be equal to 40 degree. And second method, we have AD is equal to BC. So if AD is A, then BC, it will be A. And now, if we extend BC and draw a perpendicular from A on BC, suppose this point is E and suppose this angle is theta and suppose CE is x and AE is y, then this angle here we have this angle is 100 degree, so it will be 180 degree minus 100 degree, that will be 80 degree, so it will be 80 degree. So in triangle ACE, tan 80 degree, it will be equal to AE by CE, that is equal to Y by X. So Y will be equal to X times tan 80 degree. And now we have y is equal to x times tan 80 degree, and in triangle ADE sin theta, it will be equal to AE by AD, that is equal to Y by A. So sin theta, it is equal to Y, it is X times tan 80 degree by A. So A will be equal to X times tan 80 degree by sin theta. And now in triangle ABE tan 30 degree, it will be equal to AE by BE, and AE is Y, by BE it is A plus X, and tan 30 degree, it is equal to Y, it is X times tan 80 degree by A, it is X times tan 80 degree by sin theta plus X, and tan 30 degree, it is 1 by a square root of 3, that is equal to X times tan 80 degree times sin theta by X times tan 80 degree plus X times sin theta, and X will get cancelled. So 1 by a square root of 3, it is equal to tan 80 degree times sin theta by tan 80 degree plus sin theta, and if we cross multiply, then tan 80 degree plus sin theta, it will be equal to a square root of 3 times tan 80 degree times sin theta, and tan 80 degree, it is equal to a square root of 3 times tan 80 degree sin theta minus sin theta. So tan 80 degree, it is equal to sine theta times a square root of 3 tan 80 degree minus 1. So sine theta, it will be equal to tan 80 degree by a square root of 3 times tan 80 degree minus 1. And now sine theta, it is equal to tan 80 degree, it is sine 80 degree by cos 80 degree by a square root of 3 times sine 80 degree by cos 80 degree minus 1. And sine theta, it is equal to sine 80 degree by cos 80 degree by a square root of 3 times sine 80 degree minus cos 80 degree by cos 80 degree. And cos 80 degree will get cancelled. So sine theta, it is equal to sine 80 degree by a square root of 3 sine 80 degree minus cos 80 degree. And now here, if we multiply with 2 and divide with 2, then sine theta, it is equal to sine 80 degree by 2 times sine 80 degree times a square root of 3 by 2, it is cos 30 degree minus cos 80 degree times and 1 by 2, it is sine 30 degree. And sine A cos B minus cos A sine B, it is equal to sine A minus B. And also sine 2A, it is equal to 2 sine A cos A. So sine theta, it is equal to sine 80 degree, it will be 2 times sine 40 degree times cos 40 degree by 2 times, and this will be sine 80 degree minus 30 degree, and 2 will get cancelled, and sine theta, it is equal to sine 40 degree times cos 40 degree by sine 50 degree. And sine 90 degree minus theta, it is equal to cos theta. So sine 50 degree, it will be equal to cos 40 degree. So this will get cancelled. So sine theta, it is equal to sine 40 degree. That means theta will be equal to 40 degree.